HILA's subunits are transported to the periplasm through the SEC-YEG transporter in the inner membrane, where a chaperone assists in the folding and transports of subunits to the usher situated in the outer membrane. Here the subunits polymerize and are assembled into a pilus, which can be divided into a thin tip fibrillum and a helically wound rod, which is composed of 1,000 copies of the major pilus subunit PAP-A. In this article, we solved the 3.8 angstrom resolution structure of the type P pilus rod using cryo-electron microscopy. The structure of the PAP-A monomer could be built in its entirety. From residues 1 to 5, the very end terminal end is termed the staple because of the multiple interfaces it makes with other subunits. The complementing end terminal extension strand starts from residue 6 and ends at residue 19 and inserts into the groove of the adjacent subunit. The sequence after the end terminal extension forms the pilin fold. The subunit-subunit interactions network within the pilus rod is strikingly large, with each subunit burying 45.5% of its total surface area. Such a large interaction network is at least in part due to the N-terminal extension. While the N-terminal extension-mediated interaction is strong, the other interfaces between subunits are weaker, explaining why the rod can uncoil under shear forces without breaking apart. We mutated residues at subunit-subunit interfaces, and our results show that these mutations affect rod formation, but not polymerization. Another set of mutations was made to evaluate the biological impact of interface residues on pilus biogenesis and quaternary structure in vivo. All mutants produced PAP-A polymers, but the resulting filaments appear to have reduced quaternary structural stability consistent with their position in the structure.